First of all, I would like to express my sincere thanks for the Buddhist Society of National University of Singapore for organizing this public talk by taking great pains and troubles, using great effort. As young Buddhists, they have shown their skill and ability to encourage others to follow these noble teachings of the Buddha. The subject tonight we have to discuss is three basic principles in human life. As human beings, we must have some principles. Otherwise, it is impossible for us to distinguish or to show any superiority complex that we are higher than the other living beings. Because there is a saying in Sanskrit language, Ahara Nidra Bhai Maithunancha Samanya Metat Pasubhir Narana. Eating, sleeping, sex, and self-preservation. These four things are very common in every living being in this universe. If human beings also spend their life only for eating, sleeping, experiencing sex, and fighting for their life, what have we got to prove that we are higher than the other living being or animals? There is dharmo hite sang adhiko visesa. There is an extraordinary characteristics in human life, that is dharma. This dharma you cannot find in other living beings, because human intelligence is far superior to all the other existing living beings in the whole universe. That is why human mind learned to appreciate the dharma by using that intelligence. On the other hand, you will be surprised to hear that human beings are the only living beings in this universe who have a religion. Even devas, brahmas have no particular religion. We worship them, do some offerings in the name of devas and brahmas. But we do not know that our human intelligence is far superior to their intelligence. That is why a deva or a brahma cannot become a Buddha. Only a human being can become a Buddha because of that intelligence. there are four kinds of religions in this world. Revealed religions, organized religions, institutional religions, and natural religions. Revealed religions, a message given by the God through a messenger or prophet, commandment or religious laws to maintain humanity. People strongly believe and accept that as a revealed religion. Organized religions. Before religions come into existence, human beings had humanism, not related to any religion. By knowing the humane qualities, virtues, characters, they organize certain practices, belief according to their way of thinking to govern the whole mankind. Shame and fear, these two things govern humanity. Institutional religion, introduced religious way of life in such a way by thinking very deeply, psychology, philosophy, and various other intellectual aspects to organize mankind or humanity to maintain their dignity, to respect their human intelligence, to cultivate humane qualities, to live peacefully without facing enormous problems and worries and sufferings and disturbances. Then, natural religions. When people could not understand the real nature of natural phenomena, natural occurrences, they had some sort of belief that there will be some sort of supernatural power behind all these incidents, such as lightning or thunder, rain, rainbow, and volcanic eruptions, and epidemic, flood, natural disasters, and various other natural occurrences. Therefore, they started to worship, to pray, do some offerings to avoid certain misfortune as well as to gain something through the influence of such unknown, unimaginable forces. So natural religion started in this way. Buddhism is not belong to any of these four groups. In fact, although we use the word religion, when you define the word religion from the dictionary, we cannot satisfy with that explanation, because Buddhism has gone beyond that. So the most suitable word for the teachings of the Buddha is dharma, not religion, but a common usage. We have no other choice. We say it is a religion. What is dharma? It is very meaningful. Because in religion we cannot find such deep meaning. Chatusu apayesu ca vatta dukkhesu ca appatamane katva dhareti iti dhamma. Definition. The noble way of life that support us, uphold, without allowing us to get into unfortunate state of suffering, such as hell, animal, or spirit, or ghost, or devils, or unfortunate living being. So if we follow the dharma hold us, support us, without allowing us to fall or to get into any of those unfortunate state of suffering. See how meaningful it is. That is the definitions of Buddhism. Buddhism is not a revealed religion. The Buddha did not get any message from heaven or from God. He never had any teacher to teach him how to gain enlightenment. Name acharyo atthi, he said. I never had any teacher to tell me, to teach me how to gain enlightenment. What I did, by using my full effort, eradicating, uprooting all the evil thoughts, words and action, life after life, by cultivating all the great qualities, virtues, by purifying my mind, I gained this enlightenment. Therefore, you can understand that Buddhism is not belong to any of these religious groups. It is the result of a great man who had courage to sacrifice his pleasure, his life, his time, to cultivate life after life in searching the absolute truth. There are many kind of truths. All are not absolute truths. They remain as truth for a certain period. Later, we will come to know that it is not the real truth. The truth revealed or realized or the preached by the Buddha is absolute truth, because There is nobody in this world who can single out even one word uttered by the Buddha as truth, according to their scientific or psychological or modern discoveries, to disprove. So far they could not do that. It is an absolute truth. No one can change. The Buddha also cannot change. The God also cannot change. Human beings also cannot change. Truth is truth. This is the nature of Buddhism. Then, human beings, human principle. What are the basic human principle? Here we mention three. What is the meaning of human? Pali and Sanskrit or many other languages use the word manushya. It's a very meaningful word. Manasa ussamata. Only living being who can raise, who can cultivate, who can develop the mind up to the maximum level. That living being is called manushya, human. The man, the word man is derived from mana, mind. One who got a mind to think, that person is called man. When you say man, please remember woman also included. Without woman, there is no man. Then, the Chinese definitions of humanity. Chinese philosophers say, human beings must have human-heartedness. In that human-heartedness, there must be sympathy and honesty. If these two qualities are not there in their humanity, they are not real human beings. Chinese philosophers. Western philosophers define human as those who can use their sense of reasoning, especially Greece. They say human beings are the only living beings who can use their sense of reasoning. But many other living beings use only their instinctive power for their survival, for their pleasure, for their protection. They cannot go beyond that. But human mind can penetrate, can go through any existing matters or elements of the world system in this whole universe. There is no such energy that we can compare. The Buddha said in Anguttara Nikaya, Nāhaṁ bhikkhave anyaṁ eka dhammampi samudupassāmi yathaidaṁ bhikkhave cittaṁ. Cittaṁ bhikkhave lahu parivarta. He says, I have never seen another dynamic energy other than human mind, that which runs so rapidly.